And welcome to the last review ever on Roblox. Well, I'm going to simply put this out and say my opinions so far on the games I get SE in, let's say, 20 minutes. So when that clock hits 10:30, about. Now, let's start for the most basic one, Jailbreak. I think that's the stupidest game so far. It's kind of killing itself, but at the same time, it's successful on it. Like, you don't do jailbreak. You're in jail, and either people help you, or you get dazed by police. Or you just do online dating, or you buy an apartment, which is something I don't see. They just call it life simulator instead. Puga Puga is new. I haven't tried it, so I can't say much about it. Meep City, you already know my opinions about it, but my opinions is now stronger. I fucking hate this. Look at this, using an emoji. This is cancerous. This yells online dating, which is, in the rule of Roblox, not legal. This is illegal, you know. I haven't tried much of a restaurant, but it's like what it sounds, but with ton of loot boxes. If you love loot opening loot boxes, this game is done for you. Otherwise, I don't like this. Phantom Forces. I'm not a fan of shooting games. I haven't played this in ages, so I can't say my opinions too much about it. Then it's these two same games by two different people, but do different things and have different names. Bloxburg, online dating, and you live in a city. Roll high school, instead of a city, you do high school. And it has a Valentine update. Culture Blocks is just own version of CSGO, pretty much. And I don't like CSGO, so I don't like this game automatically. Roblox High School is pretty much the original version of this, but this is older, and I still hate this, and I don't understand why people want to go to virtual school when real life school is the worst. I don't play Dragon Ball, so I don't say anything. But now, the Pokemon part. I have a lot of opinions about this game. A ton of opinions. Mostly, the story feels flat. Extremely flat. The grunts don't have any personality. Well, barely at all. The story of the evil is like every team in every Pokemon, and they're referencing too much of the other Pokemons. It's not doing full original job here. Like, it's just saying, let's do reference this and this and this. Team Magma, Team Aqua, Team Rocket, Team that, Team that. It's not having originality. This is what it struggles about, that, in my opinion. It doesn't have an original good story. Also, one thing that also bothers me, if it shows, that the guy who made music for this is no longer credited, even in the intro. I can show it to you, but I'm too lazy and I don't want to do it. It's not even in the credits in the game, which is automatically down. I don't know why it was up. I probably liked it before, but now I don't. Now, Murder Mystery 2. Just as bad as Murder Mystery 1. Or it has some improvements, but it's still bad. If you I can't say the word. Car Simulator. It's just Car Simulator. You get cars or buy cars or do something with cars to get more cars. That's it. Mining Simulator is pretty much the style as you dig ore all day and do nothing more. You already know my opinions about work at Pizza Place. The opinions stay the same. And it doesn't have really fixed anything, which is the funnier part. Adopt Me is in a way in Meep City, but still very cancerous. Zombie Attack, I don't like this zombie attack game so much. They're very bad. Epic minigames, worst version of any minigame. Liberty Tycoon 2, some realistic into it, it's not that bad. Earl Citizens, online dating, Adopt and Race, Prison Life, I haven't actually touched this, but I might. Adopt and Race, a baby, is in a way Adopt Me, but less popular and stupider. Prison Life, when I see this, I feel like I'm looking at version like Jailbreak. Actually, let me read the description. I haven't touched this game, so let me read real quick. Yeah, it's in a way a version like Jailbreak, but not successful. As successful, I mean. Flee the facility. It's like running away from work. Yeah, it sounds like it. I haven't touched this either, so I can't say much. Is there any other games? Furry is the worst thing I ever get in my mind. Theme Park Tycoon. Like, it's so small now. You can't, even it has new stuff, you can't have more space in it. It should just have a creative mode so you can just make your theme park of your dreams with infinite money and such. Like, I don't have any more room for any of the new updates. Flood Escape 2, it actually, ironically, is better than the first one. It got more floods, it's more escape, more obby, it's more difficult, and everything. It's actually it's solid, actually. Not a disaster, it's classic, I guess. Every Tycoon game ever, speedrun run, it's just cash grabbing or view play grabber. Anymore. There's just anime games that just waste the time. And I think that's it. Reason to Die. Oh, I always wanted to talk about this game. Always. Now, Reason to Die is probably the worst game I've ever played. Second to, it's like trying to be Apocalypse Rising, but it's worse. Like, I thought Apocalypse Rising had some balanced issues. This game is just piss. Plain out piss. Like, if someone pissed on your carpet and made you lick on it, this is this game. Like, this is the one that pissed, this is the carpet owner, this is the guy who pissed on it. And they're asking you to lick on the carpet. This is what the game is. Also, one last thing. One more thing. Retail Tycoon is, how I explained it, It's getting better and better. It's actually surprisingly listening. There's also more games in the future. Oh, yeah. I haven't forgotten that. I once, as you know, I did a review of Clone Tycoon, right? It got worse. I gave it, said how it could get better, what is wrong, and what is right, and somehow it made itself worse. It's just bad. Just don't play it ever. Just kill it. With fire. Piss fire. Retail Taken, I respect, is actually not that bad. I haven't played it in a while, so I can't say much about it now. But either way, when I played it, it's pretty good. But also where a time, it's also where I had to be. Shadowrun, what the fuck? Anyway, that's all the games I played. And that's my opinions on all of them in short words. If they had a good gameplay, which I doubt that'll ever happen. Good story, which that will also happen. This is the actually only story game that is popular, and it's still in beta. Like, there's a lot of stuff that there's a lot of games I know they'll arrive on Roblox. Oh yeah, that reminds me of a game. Be right back. CMag Games, one of the most amazing developers I ever poked at. These guys are amazing. Even though they're making a pirate of games, the story they have on this, and mostly this as well, is breathtaking. Like, people should just listen to these guys. I already threw money at their faces. If there's this helps them grow, then I appreciate that. I hope they continue on making good games and with good stories, characters, and a lot more. This doesn't have much characters yet, but I plan to have a story, and I hope the story and the characters, all of them, is amazing and interesting. Now, that's actually it. See, my games is probably one I respect. One developer group I respect a lot. So that's it. That's it. I'm done now reviewing. So, what do you think? So this is probably then the last video ever you'll see on this channel. My last review on this channel. And every last video on this channel. What this means is, sadly, Lupus leaves, and he even said to me he misses YouTube. It's hard for him to move on, but he have to, because he have a life, and I have a life, and we all do. But remember, I hate you too. And I'll see you minions later.